Forget Dracula. Forget Romero. Evolution's darkest secret isn't a monster that creates zombies. It's a creature that becomes one. Look at this. This isn't a snail having a rave. Those pulsating, candy-striped horns are not its own. They are a parasite, a puppet master, that has hijacked this snail's body and is now wearing its eyeballs as a costume. This isn't an infection. It's an invasion. And in the next 10 minutes, we're going to peel back the slime and show you exactly how this parasite turns a living creature into its own personal, sacrificial getaway vehicle. So here's our first shocking claim. How do you convince a creature that hates sunlight and loves hiding in the damp, dark dirt to climb to the highest, most exposed leaf in the middle of the day? The answer is, you don't. You perform a hostile takeover of its body and turn its head into a throbbing, psychedelic billboard for death. The mastermind behind this gruesome puppet show is a parasitic flatworm, Leucochloridium paradoxum. Our story begins, as so many horrifying stories do, with bird poop. An unsuspecting amber snail is just munching on some leaves, doing its snail thing, when it accidentally swallows the parasite's eggs. Inside the snail, these eggs hatch and begin to multiply, forming long, branching tubes called brood sacs. These aren't just simple worms. They are pulsating, alien-esque incubators filled with hundreds of larval parasites. And they have one mission: get inside a bird's stomach. To do that, they need to get the snail eaten. And this is where the body snatching kicks into high gear. The brood sacs snake their way through the snail's body and invade its eye stalks. They swell, distending the snail's own tissue until it becomes a transparent, throbbing sack of worms, striped green and brown and black. They pulsate in hypnotic rhythm, perfectly mimicking a juicy, wriggling caterpillar, a bird's favorite snack. The snail is no longer a snail. It's a living lure. Think about that. This is the biological equivalent of waking up one morning to find your own arm has morphed into a perfect, wiggling hot dog, developed a mind of its own, and is now dragging you towards a starving grizzly bear, all while flashing a neon sign that says, "Free lunch." It's not just an infection. It's a complete, hostile rebranding of your body parts into an advertisement for your own predator. But this gruesome visual display is useless if the target audience, the bird, can't see it. So how does the parasite solve the fundamental problem of a snail that is biologically programmed to hide from the light? That brings us to the next, even more sinister revelation. The parasite doesn't just give the snail a grotesque makeover. It fundamentally rewires its brain, turning a shy, nocturnal hermit into a suicidal exhibitionist. The scientific term for this is behavioral manipulation, but let's call it what it is: mind control. Healthy snails have a negative phototaxis, a fancy way of saying they run from the light like a vampire at sunrise. It's a core survival instinct. But snails infected with Leucochloridium do the exact opposite. They develop a fatal attraction to the spotlight. The parasite, likely through chemical secretions, hijacks the snail's central nervous system, effectively flipping a switch in its brain from hide to seek. It forces the snail to abandon the safety of the dark and climb to the most conspicuous places imaginable, the very top of plants, out in the open, where birds can easily spot their new, pulsating caterpillar eyes. Let the horror of this sink in. The snail is still in there. Its brain, the tiny cluster of neurons that for millions of years has screamed, "Danger, sunlight, bird," is being chemically gagged and silenced by a squatter who is not only living in its head, but is actively trying to get their shared apartment eaten. This is the biological equivalent of a malicious hacker gaining root access to your self-driving car's OS, disabling all safety features, and flooring it towards a cliff, all while locking the doors and blaring German techno music. The snail isn't just a vehicle anymore. It's a prisoner in the passenger seat of its own body, forced to perform a final, fatal, sun-drenched dance for its killer. So, the parasite turns the snail into a pulsating, light-seeking zombie machine. But what happens when the bird finally takes the bait and rips its face off? The story doesn't end there. It gets even more gruesomely efficient. What happens inside the bird? And that leads us to the final chilling piece of the puzzle. The parasite's goal isn't really to kill the snail. The snail's death is just collateral damage. The real endgame is to use the snail's body as a disposable ticket to the parasite's twisted version of a reproductive, VIP lounge, a bird's rectum. Here's the science. The bird, seeing what it thinks is a delicious caterpillar, swoops down and rips off the snail's infected eye stalks. Inside the bird's warm, cozy digestive tract, the larval parasites finally mature into adult flatworms. They find a partner, reproduce like there's no tomorrow, and create thousands of new eggs. These eggs mix with the bird's waste and are unceremoniously pooped out all over the forest floor. And just like that, the trap is reset, waiting for another unsuspecting snail to start the whole nightmare over again. And get this for a final, cruel twist. Sometimes the bird only eats the eye stalks. A snail can survive the attack, blinded and maimed. It then regenerates its eye stalks, only for the remaining brood sacs inside its body to invade the new ones, turning it back into a zombie lure for a second time. Let's be perfectly clear about what this means. The entire elaborate horror show the mind control, the body snatching, the grotesque physical transformation, the forced suicide march into the sunlight, all of it is just an incredibly complicated transportation strategy. The snail is a disposable, sometimes reusable, Uber ride to an orgy. Its life and suffering are nothing more than a single functional step in an algorithm of pure, unfeeling survival. This isn't evil. This is efficiency. It's an evolutionary strategy of such cold, calculating brutality that it makes a supervillain's monologue sound like a sentimental nursery rhyme. The zombie snail was never the main character in its own story. It was just act one in a never-ending horror franchise. This cycle is brutally, terrifyingly perfect. But it forces us to ask one final question. If natural selection, this blind, purposeless force, can engineer a real-life zombie apocalypse this precise, what other dark secrets is it hiding in the shadows? So there you have it. Evolution's darkest secret isn't a myth or a monster from a B-movie. It's a flatworm, a master manipulator that hijacks a snail's mind and body, transforming it into a living, breathing, zombie lure with one purpose: to get eaten. It is a story of body snatching, mind control, and forced suicide, all orchestrated not by some cosmic evil, but by the cold, impartial calculus of natural selection. This entire horrifying process exists for one reason, and one reason only: because it works. This is the ultimate lesson of weird evolution. The natural world has no heroes or villains. There is only what survives, and the strategies for survival are often more brutal, more bizarre, and more terrifying than anything we could ever invent. Nature isn't just red in tooth and claw. Sometimes it's a pulsating, mind-controlled eye stalk being offered up to the sky. If you know of an even weirder evolutionary nightmare that we need to cover, weaponize that knowledge and unleash it in the comments below. For more deep dives into the beautiful, terrifying logic of nature's dark side, make sure to subscribe and sacrifice the bell icon to the algorithm gods. And if you want to help us fund these expeditions into the evolutionary abyss, consider supporting the channel on Patreon. Every dollar helps us uncover the next secret. Now go look at a flower or something. You've earned it.